LA Situation Room in Roy, New Mexico. You're listening to The Snowplow Show.
Now it's time
on Prank Call Nation.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. I'm playing games.
Cactus.
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 Am I supposed to be doing this?
Cactus.
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 Cactus, this cocksucker.
Cactus.
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 You've got to be crap on my ball.
Cactus.
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 This is going to be a fuck job to edit.
Cactus.
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 You're calling me a hobo.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. Roy, the retarded boy.
Cactus.
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 How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
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 Cactus. You blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
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 You think a tracer can stop me?
Hello, everybody. This is Brad / Roy / RB / RBCP. And you're listening to The Snowplow Show. It's Monday, October 27th, 2014. I'm not going to try and trick you and say it's 2011 this time. I just did that for the chat room last time. I wanted to trick them into thinking they're listening to an old show. But I always do that. It's getting old. I need to cut it out. Today is a very special day because it's Mistress Morgan's birthday. Happy birthday, Mistress Morgan. Also today, Stephen Aspinwall, he's trying to steal the limelight from Mistress Morgan. It's also his birthday. I only know this because my Skype popped up. It says, it's Stephen Aspinwall's birthday. He has a flaccid penis. So I guess happy birthday to him too, but not really. Mostly, this is a happy birthday Mistress Morgan show. Now, I was actually thinking about doing a live show this morning, but Mistress Morgan's not even online. She's not in the chat room. She's going to do a birthday special, but no, she's not around. So no live show for you, Mistress Morgan. And it's late in the morning now, too. It's like one in the afternoon. But it's probably for the best, because I was really tired this morning. I probably would have been terrible at a live show. Back in the cacti radio days, you know, back when we had a thing called cacti radio and I did the phone show, I had this thing made for people who have birthdays. And I haven't made a new one for Snowplow Show, but I'm going to play this. This is for you, Mistress Morgan, and sort of you, Stephen Aspinwall, but not really. Mostly Mistress Morgan.
To you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday from Cacti Radio, happy birthday to you.
Aw, that was so beautiful. Today's Mistress Morgan Happy Birthday Extravaganza show is sponsored by Jason Bennett. Jason Bennett is a Patreon person who contributes to the show, makes me feel obligated to do shows all the time. So thank you, Jason Bennett, for the support. For sponsoring the show, for being the today's fall guy, if I should need a fall guy on today's show. So today I woke up, I looked on Facebook, and the first thing I see is this amazing PLA pumpkin from Jiad. I think it's Jiad, and I always call him Jiad, and now everyone else calls him Jiad. Anyway, he carved a PLA pumpkin, a pumpkin with the Phone Losers, you know, lightning bolt bell logo thing in it, and it looks pretty amazing. People have done it before, but I think this is probably the best picture we have of one, because like Altalp did one 10 years ago, but cameras sucked back then, so it's all blurry and stuff from her, I think she took the picture with a sidekick, actually. And I think Dark Stranger was telling me just a few weeks ago that I really need to have another PLA pumpkin carving contest, because I've done those in the past. Well, I've done one in the past, at least. I think it was back in 2009, and there were some really amazing entries that year. I didn't think anyone was going to do anything cool, and there were some really amazing pumpkins people made, you know, PLA-related pumpkins. And they're all up on the Facebook. If you go to facebook.com/phonelosers, look in the photo albums, there's a section called Happy Halloween, and you can see all the pumpkins there. And in the show notes, I am going to put a link to that photo album, so you can see all these amazing pumpkins from years ago. And I added Jiad's pumpkins in there. And I thought Jiad only had two kids, but holy crap, there are like 10 or 12, I think, maybe even more pumpkins that they've carved out. In his garage, it looks like. Jiad went really overboard on his pumpkin carving this year. But I'm not complaining, because there's a cool PLA bell symbol. I'll make that the image for today's podcast on phonelosers.org. But yes, I need to do another PLA pumpkin carving contest. Not this year, but hopefully next year I will remember to do that. Someone should remind me. Pumpkin carving contest. Starting October 1st of 2015. Something I've been putting off for a while now is an update on Curtis the Super Hacker. Curtis Lee Jones. Earlier this month, somebody posted on the Curtis page on phonelosers.org, which is phonelosers.org/Curtis. They posted an update on him, and it looks like he's had some troubles with the law recently. And I guess a lot of listeners probably don't know who the hell Curtis is. He is a guy that back in 2002, maybe 2003, there was a story about him on FARC. And he's just this old guy who is really into Satanism and is really angry, hangs out in chat rooms, stalks women. I don't know how to explain it all. The best way to find out who Curtis is to go to phonelosers.org/Curtis. There is a giant collection of phone calls to Curtis, and you just get to hear Curtis just do his thing at us. He just yells and says all these crazy things. I'm going to play the first clip on the page. I don't really remember what this is, what he says in this, but it's called Impression Footprints. The description says, this clip really captures the essence of Curtis. By the way, you know, 2002, 2003, bad phone quality. So prepare for that.
Curtis.
Hey, what's up, man? How you like your fucking little gay-ass shit, boy?
My gay-ass shit?
Yeah.
What's gay-ass about me?
What do you mean, what's gay about you, man? You're fucking all gay, motherfucker.
Well, I don't have an email address that says KurtTeddyBear316.
That ain't shit, dude. You need to do your homework, motherfucker. You ain't doing shit, motherfucker.
Why are you a teddy bear?
Oh, you need to go.
So his email address on Yahoo at the time was KurtTeddyBear. That was his name. Because he's a cuddly teddy bear Satanist guy.
Go back and look again, son. I guess you're just not doing too good.
I guess not.
All right, that one's boring. Let's go to this one.
Everybody thought they were fucking 10 times as fucking bulletproof as fucking Superman. You know where they ended up? In the palm of my fucking hand.
Yeah, right.
Dude, if I slap it, they all go. You may laugh now, dude.
Slap it.
But as soon as those motherfuckers get to your fucking police station, which is going to take a little bit, then they're going to knock at the door, and they're going to fucking wipe your little fucking monkey ass up like fucking a puddle of water, and you're going to be sitting in a deep pile of fucking shit fucking crying for your mom. Are you ever going to wake up? You know, truthfully, man, are you ever going to wake up?
Yeah, right.
You're picking a fight with the fucking devil, motherfucker, and you're going to lose. They lost.
You think so?
You don't understand that, do you? They lost. I would give you two choices, dude.
What would they do?
Run like a motherfucker. And hope you ran fast.
No, I wouldn't do that.
Dude, I carry a fucking gun 24.
He did the thing again, where he says, you have two choices, but then he just says one. He doesn't understand how those work.
You would be dead before you even turned around. I'd blow the fucking one eye socket out the back of your fucking head. You made a mistake. You danced with the devil. You died by the devil. You understand that? You don't get it. Pay a fucking attention. Quit saying what? You stepped up. You danced with the devil. You're going to die by the devil. Do I make that loud and clear?
Are you the devil?
Oh, yes, buddy. I'm strictly 999 out of hell, motherfucker.
Okay, so that's Curtis. That should give you an idea of who he is, I guess. Really, you just need to go to the website, phonelosers.org/Curtis. Listen to all the calls and with, you know, all their horrible sound quality. But Curtis was, he was arrested, and he's in prison right now for dissemination of photos, videotapes, computer depictions, and films of child pornography. He was convicted earlier this year, back in April. So I guess he's going to be spending a few years in prison. At least a few years, I don't know. The last time we got an update about Curtis was back in early 2008, and we saw some kind of list of charges. He was receiving stolen property and possession of all these drugs, and he was operating a chop shop. So Curtis, he lives an exciting life. An exciting life filled with marijuana and stolen cars and apparently now child pornography. I think it was DS that said in the chat room, he's the newest inmate at the Chili Pepper Correctional Facility. Good old Curtis. Good times. Let's do some pranks. I have some numbers left over from the portrait studio people. I sent a bunch to Carlito last night for his show, and he called some. It was pretty amusing. Him and Jen did some together, and I got on the end of the show and did a few. I think maybe throughout the entire show, the 4-hour show, there's maybe 4 calls to portrait people in there, but I have a bunch of leftover numbers, so let's give some portrait people a call right now.
Hello?
Hello, Jody?
Yes, hi.
Hi, this is Roy. I'm in the loss prevention department. You were in here the other day for portraits?
Yes,
and,
yeah.
We looked at the security tapes, and we saw that you shoplifted on the way out, and you need to bring that stuff back.
Excuse me?
We saw on the security tapes that you shoplifted, and we need you to bring the things back that you stole from us.
I'm sorry, you've misunderstood something.
Oh no, the we didn't misunderstand the videotape that we have that shows that you stealing things. Like it's right on camera.
Like what?
A bunch of stuff out of the baby aisle.
I'm sorry, you've got the wrong person.
Oh, it's definitely you, because, you know, we have your name and everything. From you didn't think we'd know who you were, but then you went over to the photo department, and we have all your information from that. So I'm trying to be nice. Can't you just bring it back, and we won't have to involve authorities or anything?
I'm sorry, can I get your name?
Sure, I already told you it's Roy.
And your last name?
Well, hey, I'm not the one on trial here. Why are you stealing from us? Like, you look like you're old enough to know not to steal.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, of course you don't.
But
of course you don't.
You are affiliated with, is that correct?
Of course, yes. I already told you that.
Okay, can I speak with your manager, please?
He's not available, but he's going to tell you the same thing.
All right.
He saw you on camera, and you need to bring that stuff back.
Well, I never went through the baby aisle, so you have a misunderstanding on your hands, sir. And if you can't, let me talk to your manager right now, and if you can't give me your full name, then obviously this isn't a phone call that I'm going to reply to.
We know you went straight to the baby aisle after you had those pictures taken. So look, you don't have to bring the stuff back if you don't want to, but you can't come back in our store, because we know you're just going to steal again. So just stay out.
All right. I would like to know your name, and I would like to speak
with
you after.
Oh, wow. I already told you my name, remember?
Roy, I understand that, and I wrote it down. But I don't have your last name, so therefore, if I call back and talk with the manager,
I'm the only Roy that works here.
Just Roy? Is there one Roy?
Right, there's only one, so what does it matter what my last name is?
There's one Roy.
So you need to grow up, stop shoplifting, and stay out of our store. You understand?
I can hear you laughing. Who is this?
I did not laugh once. I'm a professional when it comes to this prank calling stuff, and I do not laugh. If I'm going to laugh, I hit the mute button.
Who is this?
So I didn't laugh. What do you mean you heard me laugh? I think you're just hearing things. I'm very offended that you're saying I'm laughing.
I'm very offended that you're accusing me of stealing.
Okay. No, I'm actually, my name is Dave. I work in the toy department. I just thought it'd be funny to call their customers over in the portrait studio department and say crazy things to them, because it's slow here today.
This is, like, unacceptable.
Yeah. Well, I mean, at least we're not throwing you out of the store, so it's fine, right?
Can I ask how you got my number?
Yeah, it's in the computer, because you had portraits done here last week.
Well, I understand that, but then you think it's okay to call people and harass them and say untrue things to them?
The people in the portrait studio, they're always playing pranks on me and my department and the people, my coworkers over here. So we're playing a prank back on them. We got in their computer and got their customers, and now we're calling their customers to get them back, you know?
I think that is absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah.
And I will be chatting with about this.
That's something a shoplifter would say.
That's perfectly fine.
Yep.
I hope you've got all of this recorded, because I do.
Really? What did you use to record this call?
A recorder.
Yeah? I don't believe that. Like, why would you have a recorder ready to go?
The thing is, where I work, we have recorders, because that's how physicians dictate things. So I am able to, whenever I need to, hit record on a speakerphone conversation.
Oh my God.
Due to where I work.
I'm totally fucked.
Yeah, you are. So, phone number of 78.
Yeah, that's the number to dummy.
Oh, well, I'll be giving them a jingle. Roy.
You want me to just transfer you?
No, that's okay. I'll call back.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Well? Hi, Chris.
Yeah.
Hey, this is David from the portrait studio.
Hi.
Hi, I just needed to let you know that our computer crashed, so we lost all your photos.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's a bummer. We have to buy a new computer and everything.
That's too bad, okay.
And, so you'll need to pay again, because we lost all your billing information, too. So basically, you just need to come in for retakes, and we'll charge you again and have your pictures redone.
But it already was taken off of my card, so.
I know, but we lost all the billing information, so we don't even know how to, we can't even refund you.
Oh, well, you will refund me.
Well, no, we can't. We don't know how. Like, the billing information.
Well, you're going to have to figure it out.
It all crashed. The computer crashed.
I'm not paying. Is this a joke or something?
No, of course not.
Well, it seems like a joke, because I paid for pictures, and if you lost my pictures, then you'll reimburse me.
Yeah, but the computer crashed.
I have proof I can show you my bill that you took it out of my account already, so.
Yeah, but, you know, like, we can't even pull up your thing to refund it, because the computer crashed.
Okay, so I paid for it once, and you expect me to bring my son in to get more pictures and pay for more pictures that I didn't receive, even though I already paid for them.
You don't have to yell at me.
I'm not yelling.
Yeah, you're yelling. You're completely yelling at me. Stop yelling at me. I don't have to take that from you.
Well, just refund me or I will be calling way higher than you can go. Goodbye.
Way higher than I can go? What does that mean?
Hello?
Hello, Andrea?
Yes?
Hey, this is Roy from the Portrait Studio. You had some photos done with us last week.
Yep.
Yep, and our hard drive crashed, and we lost all your photos, so we're going to need to have you come in for retakes.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah.
So they're not online anymore?
No, well, you know, the low-resolution ones are online, but the high-resolution ones that we print, those are all on the computer, and the hard drive crashed.
Oh, geez.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah. Well, my husband's leaving town, so... How long are you guys open?
What do you mean, today?
Yeah.
Well, we don't have anything available today. The earliest we can get you in is February 11th. Because, you know, we're really booked up for the holidays.
Okay. I'm just going to need to let you go and talk to my husband about it, okay?
Well,
thank you for calling.
Can't you make decisions on your own?
Okay, you don't need to be rude for the fact that we lost our pictures.
What?
You do not need to be rude.
We didn't lose your pictures. It's a hard drive crash. It's not our fault. But I don't see why you can't just make a decision.
I understand that, but you're asking me that. You said to me you can't make decisions on my own?
Yeah,
no,
why can't you?
No, I need to talk to my husband, thank you.
Come on, like, you know, women equality and all that shit. Why can't you just make a decision on your own?
Because I don't need you talking to me like this, okay?
Learn to think for yourself.
Do not tell me, learn to speak to you. Do not tell me that. I can think for myself. Who the fuck is your supervisor? I want to speak to them now.
Why can't I tell you anything? Your husband tells you everything else to do.
No, my husband doesn't tell me anything to do, and that's none of your fucking business.
Then why do you have to consult him? Why don't you just make a decision?
Because he's my husband, and he's part of the fucking pictures, you moron.
You shouldn't yell in front of your kids like this.
You're the one that is being a complete asshole.
Okay, but I'm
and
not...
You're the one that is calling me and telling me that I need to think for myself.
Well, I'm not cursing and yelling in front of my kids like a bad mother would.
I don't care.
Like, that's something...
Don't call me a bad mother.
That's something a bad mother would do.
I want to speak to your supervisor. Let me speak to your supervisor.
Okay, let me get the supervisor. But that's something a bad mother would do, you know, yell and curse in front of her kids.
Okay, don't talk to me. I am very heated right now. Put your supervisor on the phone.
Well, why don't you take some parenting classes? Maybe you should take some parenting classes.
Put your supervisor on the phone now.
Have you ever thought about that, taking some parenting classes?
Can you put your supervisor on the phone? I don't want to speak to you anymore, Roy, if that's your name.
The supervisor is out having a nooner.
I don't care.
Well, that means he can't come to the phone. Your husband...
Don't tell me I don't know how to be a parent. My kid is 1 year old. He doesn't know what the fuck I'm saying, you dumbass.
Well, that's how he's going to learn. He's going to learn the fuck word if you say it a bunch.
All right. Well, I'm getting off the phone. Don't ever call me again.
I
will be reporting you.
I bet you your son's first word is going to be fuck.
No, pretty sure it wasn't. He knows how to speak.
Because you're a bad mother. Oh, he knows how to speak, so you're admitting that he's going to learn this stuff from you. That's going to be his next word is fuck.
I know. I'm hanging up with you.
Good.
Hang up.
Bad mother. Did her husband say it was a scam? They always say it's a scam. Maybe I just misunderstood. I don't know. Let's listen to some performance art. Oh, I mean voicemails.
Hey, this is Bob McBobberson. And,
hey, Bob.
Just wondering what you doing right now.
Just stuff.
Just playing with my
things.
Pet raccoons in my room. And just petting them, just thinking about you, Bradley Carter.
That's
the real Brad Carter prankster. And Just wondering what you're doing. Just looking at you with some binoculars.
Oh, crap.
From my car. Sitting here. You know, just sit here overnight and just look at you. Watch what you're doing. Just looking at you, you know. Here's to you.
Stop looking at me. I'm sick of you looking at me.
Brad Carter, I want you to know that I know. I know that you and your organization have been involved in the government campaign to discredit
me. Oh shit, we can't listen to this one.
You've been shipping poison to my sheriff's department so that the sheriff can sabotage my bowl of cornflakes in the morning. And I want you to know that I know, and that you're not gonna get away with this, and that Allah has my back. You will taste the fires of hell, Brad Carter.
Ouch. Yep, so that's what I do in my spare time when I'm not making phone calls on a podcast. I'm sending poison to sheriff's offices.
Hey, listen here now. My husband listens to your show 24/7. I gotta listen to it in the house. It drives me fucking crazy. You understand? All I hear is that phone ringing. Oh my god! So I figure I give you a call and tell you about it. You know that you're getting ratings.
You should be lucky that I edit out all the ringing from these shows, because if I didn't, most of these shows would just be nothing but ringing. The people that listen to the show live, they know what I'm talking about.
At least from him, okay? Make you feel better, all right? So I figured I'd tell you that, but it still drives me crazy. But he's crazy about you guys. He loves you guys so much. And I know I have that 1-900 voice, too.
Nope.
Okay.
Nope.
Thank you. Bye.
If you say so. I mean, yes, you do. Of course you do. It's the best 1-900 voice I've ever heard. You know, if you really loved your husband, and if you want to prove it, you should buy him a bunch of Phone Losers shirts at phonelosers.spreadshirt.com. But I guess since he'll hear this before you do, I've completely ruined the surprise. But that's what a good wife would do.
Hey, Roy. I've got a prank idea for you.
Yay!
I
really need to make a form for some mini prank ideas.
That you should definitely call some people up, but have them think that they called you, whether they realize it or not. See, what you're going to do, you call somebody up, they say hello, and then you play the ring back tone. You know, the ring, 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 which lets them know.
Is that the ring back tone from the 1920s? Where I turn the crank, ring, ring, ring. I'm pretty sure phones don't do it like that anymore.
That the other line is ringing. And then you, quote-unquote, answer and act as though they called you.
Okay.
They'll be very confused and insist that they didn't call you, but that you called them. Get angry and say, no, you called me. And see what happens. When they inevitably hang up, call them back again, but from a different number and with a different voice. Maybe in Spanish. And then insist that they called you.
In my Spanish voice that I do.
Bye, Roy.
Bye. Thanks for the idea. I think I know how that call would go, because I've done that to other people. You know, like I used to bridge two people together with three-way calling and just listen to them talk to each other. And they're like, you called me. No, you called me. No, you called me. Here, let's call up a guy in the you know, in the request forms and see what he says if I do that. Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, hello. What do you... this is Brad. What do you want?
Who's this?
This is Brad. What do you need?
Who is this?
My name is Brad.
Did I call you by accident?
Yeah, I think you called me. Why'd you call me for? What do you need?
Oh, so I must have pocket dialed you.
Why would I be in your phone in the first place to pocket dial me? Who are you?
I got the call from you first.
No, you called me.
Oh.
You big liar. What are you trying to pull here? Is this a scam?
No.
This sounds like some kind of a scam. Who is this?
I don't even know who I'm talking
to. Oh, I already told you who I am. Who are you?
My name is Brent.
Oh, hey, Brent. You sound like a real jackass. You sound like the kind of guy that'd be into MMA or something. Like, why don't you learn how to use your cell phone and stop prank calling people? Prank calls are for kids. You don't sound like a kid. Motherfucker. Okay, I did it. That was the third try, by the way. I tried two other people, and when they hear the phone ring, they just hang up. They probably think they're being connected to a telemarketer or something. Or they just don't have the patience to sit there through 2 seconds of ringing. Billman sent me that number to Brent. I just picked it at random out of my prank call requests. Probably fucked up his request idea. Oops. Sorry, Billman. I'll save it, though. I'll try it again sometime soon. Your original idea, which involved MMA. Jesus, these messages are really long. Here's a short one. I'll just go to the short ones. Oh my god, you guys, stop leaving long messages.
Hey, Brad. I really like the hang up the phone pranks.
Thanks.
But I noticed that you say, like, you hang up, and the other guy's like, you hang up. And it goes back and forth a lot, and I was thinking it'd be really funny if you made it really uncomfortable, and you were like, no, you hang up. Like how, like, middle school kids do when they first get their phones.
What? I still do that. You mean I shouldn't be doing that still? And in real life, I mean?
Talking to somebody they like, and they're like, no, you hang up first. I don't know, I just thought that'd be kind of funny. Thanks a lot, bye.
I will try to remember to do that next time I do hang up the phone calls.
Roy, Brad, I just want to know, you guys are awesome, you guys are funny.
Oh.
I love watching your videos, and I steal that name Roy every time I prank call anything. I just say Roy. I watch your stuff anytime at all I'm feeling down or anything. You're awesome. And yeah, I just want to let you know how funny you are. And I do steal the crazy line. I say that the way that you do it. That's crazy. All right, man. I'm going to let you go. Cactus.
Stealing my shit. My lawyers will be in touch, motherfucker. I think that's a good place to end the voicemails for the day. Even though there's no Olga jokes this time, I kind of feel like I should keep going until I hear Olga do a joke for us. I probably should have mentioned this before I started playing voicemails and tricked you guys into listening to a bunch of voicemails that you don't care about, but I'm out of numbers. I'm done with Portrait Studios. I know there were only 3 before, but I called about 20 of them, and they either didn't work or they didn't answer, so I just gave up and deleted them. They just weren't funny, so I deleted them all. So there's only 3. And now even though I've been doing the show for like 2 hours, I'm not even up to 30 minutes on this show. I think I'm gonna have to make this a short show. I also did a bunch of prank requests earlier this morning, and none of those would work out. It's just been a bad day for pranking overall. This one guy wanted me to call up his sister. She just bought a house with her boyfriend, and he wanted me to call her up and tell her while she's at work, I took her roof off. And I took it one step further. And I told her I was with Chase Manhattan, and we were foreclosing on a home on her street, but we got the address wrong. We accidentally foreclosed on her home instead. So we drilled out her locks and packed up everything in her house into a moving van. And the movers, Royco Moving, of course, they've already left, and they're on their way to New York with all of her stuff. And we can't get a hold of him. He's not answering his phone. And as hilarious as all that sounds, it wasn't funny. The girl was just... just upset mostly. And she hung up on me. I called her back and left her a voicemail. I'm like, hey, just kidding. I'm a friend of your boyfriend's. And we thought it'd be funny to play a little joke on you. And then I sent the guy an email. Who was it? It was Gizmo. Gizmo emailed me that prank. I sent him an email and told him what happened. You know, so he could prepare for whatever fallout there was. But he's like, whatever. She deserves it anyway. What a great brother. But yeah, there was a lot like that. I did about 10 prank requests today, and they just sucked. Maybe I just sucked today. Maybe they would have been awesome if I didn't suck so much. If your prank request does not get played, though, it's not because I didn't try. I tried. Please don't send me your prank request twice, because it seems like that happens a lot. I'll be going through the requests, and I see one that I've done before already, and goddammit, cut it out. I came across an interesting telephone number this week. It's a disconnected phone number, or at least temporarily disconnected, I guess. And the provider of the phone number is a very small telephone company called Sierra Telephone. But check out what happens when I call this disconnected number.
to your telephone. What number have you dialed, please?
559-692.
Thank you. That number has been temporarily disconnected. Calls are being referred to area code 559-72.
Okay. Thank you, Mabel.
Thank you. All right. Thank you.
Bye. Isn't that crazy? It's like they're living in the 1940s or something. The phone number was located in this town called Coarse Gold, California, which used to be a gold rush mining town back in the 1800s, according to their Wikipedia page. Holy crap, I was looking on their Wikipedia page, and one of the entries says this: every year in this town from mid-October to mid-November, tarantula mating season takes place, and the town is full of tarantulas. Locals go out of their way to protect and respect their arachnids during this time, and they even have a tarantula festival. And at the festival, they have a contest related to tarantulas, and it's a competition for the hairiest legs on both men and women. This town sounds hilarious. Wow, their elementary school teaches some kind of old Indian dialect class for the kids called Chuck Chansey. This is the weirdest town ever. And this tarantula festival's happening right now. Like, somebody that lives around that area of Coarse Gold, California, you should go up there and visit the tarantula festival and take pictures of tarantulas for me. Anyway, I just thought the telephone thing was interesting. Like, that's the kind of thing you see in old movies and TV shows where, you know, they turn the crank on the telephone and you talk to Mabel and she connects your number. I'm sure their telephone system isn't like that, you know, just to dial a number that's working. But apparently they don't know how to set up disconnected recordings on their system or something. I was about to end the show and I finally got a prank request to pick up and to be somewhat amusing. So here's a prank request. It's from, he says his name is Roy. I'm kind of doubting that. He also says he works at a store named Hobo, but that's just the initials for the store, and maybe I shouldn't give the name of the store. I think I'm not going to do that, because I don't want this guy to get in trouble, because I know what you listeners are like. You'll call up, you'll look up the store and call it up and try and get Roy in trouble. Fake Roy. But he says this customer bought a whole kitchen set of cabinets. Tell him that before he bought them, that there's a bunch of rats in them, and make up something like you always do. And he tells me the guy's name is Steven, gives me his address and his phone number. And I just called it a minute ago, and he picked up. And here it goes. I'm going to play it for you.
Hello?
Hello, Steven?
Yes.
Hi, this is Brad. I work over at the bargain outlet. You bought some cabinets?
Hi.
Hi, you bought some cabinets from us?
I did, and then I returned them.
Oh, you returned them?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm glad you're willing to admit that, because when you returned them, they had termites in them.
I only had them for maybe 2 days. I brought one in my house and it didn't match, so I only opened one of them.
Yeah, well, I mean, the one that you opened, it was filled with termites. And
termites.
Yeah, and they spread to the rest of the store. Basically, our store is just infested with termites now, and it's your fault.
Okay.
So was it just some kind of prank? You thought it'd be funny to infest our store with termites?
Are you joking me right now, man?
No, of course not. This is ridiculous. We've had to close down for the day. We have to wait for the exterminator to get here.
Dude, I had them in my house.
And your house has kitchen. Your house has termites then?
No, my house does not have termites in it.
Well, have you checked lately? Because this sure was filled up with termites, and it wasn't when you left here with it.
Dude, there was nothing on the cabinet when I took it back.
Yeah, it was all inside the cabinet. It's completely filled with termites.
Well, that's odd, man. I don't have any termite issues in my house.
Well, we have termite issues here now, and you're responsible for it. And I think you should have to pay for the exterminator. He's going to charge...
Dude, I'm not going to pay for an exterminator.
He's going to charge $600 to do our whole store and get rid of all the termites that you brought in.
I'll look in my house right now, and if I find termites, I'll call you back.
Okay, well, this is bullshit. You don't even seem to care. You're acting like it's not your fault. I tried to call Steven back. I called probably 15 times. It rang 4 times each, and he never picked up. I left him a voicemail, and I'm like, you know what, Steven? I know where you live, and maybe I'll just bring over a bunch of bed bugs and throw them in your yard. How do you like that, motherfucker? And then I thought better of it, and I deleted the voicemail. And didn't leave a voicemail. Because, you know, that's kind of a threat, and I don't know.
That's really too bad he wouldn't pick up, though. I really wanted him to pick up. I feel like this show needs one more prank, so I'm going to end the show with an old prank. You've probably heard it before. It's a couple years old. On YouTube, it's called Recycling Tight Little Sexy Pizza Boxes. And I always like this one, so I'm just going to play you guys an old prank, just in case you haven't heard it yet. So here's an old prank. Enjoy this.
Hello?
Hi, is Dave there?
No, he's not.
Do you know when he'll be back?
No, why?
Oh, I'm calling from the pizza. My name is Roy. I was just calling about the box, the pizza box. Are you guys finished with your pizza?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, we just need to send a delivery driver over to retrieve the box for the recycling program.
Oh, well, no, there's still pizza here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, if you could put that in like a Tupperware or something, that'd be great, because we need to retrieve the box so we can use it
for... Do you want the box from the wings, too?
Just the pizza is all we're recycling right now. The wings are fine. We just need the pizza box.
Okay.
Because we're going to use that for the next customer, and we're running low on boxes tonight because it's been really busy.
Oh,
so we need
okay.
we need to get the box back. Is it very greasy? Or is it okay? I mean, is it?
Yeah, it's kind of greasy.
Okay, we'll clean it up.
You know, pan pizzas are greasy.
Yeah, they are. We'll use Windex. We spray Windex on the bottom and it cleans it up pretty good.
Right.
Yeah, we just need to come get the box back. So we're going to send a driver over. He's going to knock on your door.
Okay.
And you're going to have to give the box back. Or otherwise, we're going to charge you $7.39. That's how much the box is worth.
Uh-huh, right.
Yep.
$7.39.
For the
then
box.
You can have the whole pizza, and I want a refund for the pizza.
Well, you know, it's just the recycle program. It's like the new millennium. We have to recycle everything. Fucking tree.
Okay.
Fucking tree huggers.
Uh-huh.
That's what I'm saying.
Right.
Fucking tree huggers. Goddamn tree. Where's Dave? Like, didn't he stay and eat the pizza with you?
Yeah. He's outside.
Oh, he's outside. I thought you meant he left.
Well, he's outside smoking.
What's he smoking? Like cigarettes or weed?
Cigarettes. Cigarettes.
You guys don't like smoke weed and then eat some pizza?
Nope.
Why not? Like, you should smoke a little bit of weed and just try it once, okay?
No,
we
don't
have,
do that no more.
We have kind of a side program here. If you get the right delivery driver, you can get a little bit of weed with your pizza.
Uh-huh, right.
I'm serious. You don't need to treat me like a goddamn fucking liar.
No, I don't want it.
Okay, that's fine.
I don't.
Okay, whatever.
But do you always talk to people like that about picking up a pizza box?
Only,
and then,
only when I'm really drunk. That's the only time I do that.
Why do they have you calling people?
I don't know. It's like it's really busy tonight. It's really busy. We just need to get that pizza box back. It's been a bad night. I had to fire some kid tonight, some teenager that just started last week, because he was like smeared his ass on the pizza. Some guy
gross.
Named Dang 420. Yeah, it's not your pizza. Don't worry about it. It's not your pizza. Someone else.
I hope not.
No, I made your pizza, and I did not smear my ass on your pizza.
Okay.
I'm just, I promise.
Is this a serious phone call?
Well, I mean, yeah, more or less. We just need to get the box back.
I mean, are you serious? You want my pizza box?
Oh, yeah, it's a recycling program. We've been doing this since 2007. We get the pizza boxes back, and then we use them for the next customer. We clean them up. With bleach.
Well, we've never had anybody call us and want our pizza box before.
Really? Here at this pizza place? Because we mix bleach and we mix bleach and ammonia. We mix it together and we clean up the bottom of the pizza box, and it's like brand new.
Yeah, nobody's ever called me and asked me for my pizza box.
You should try it. You should try mixing bleach and ammonia, like in a small room.
No, thanks.
Okay. it's a good way to clean up your stuff, you know, like dishes and stuff.
Well, I know, you know, we used to use a lot of bleach when I worked at the convenience store. So
yeah.
When we cleaned, you know.
Did you ever mix it with ammonia though? Because that's what really that's what really makes things clean. You mix bleach and ammonia. You do it in a small closed-in area so that it mixes together perfectly, like a closet. Or the bathroom. And,
okay.
And it cleans the motherfucking shit out of things.
Oh.
It cleans the...
Okay, your pizza box is ready.
Okay. All right, you got it in Tupperware.
What, our pizza?
Yeah. You got the pizza.
I took the pizza out of the box.
Okay. If you want to just leave it out on the porch, our delivery driver will pick it up.
Okay, I can do that. I can leave it outside by the front door.
Okay, and that way we won't have to bother you. Because we have this one joker. We have this one joker of a delivery driver. He'll take your box, and he thinks this is really clever. He thinks this is funny. But he'll say, "Oh, this is such a nice box. You have a nice box, ma'am. I really like your box."
Oh, okay.
He thinks it's funny. He thinks it's like a pun or something. He'll take your box.
Oh.
He'll be like,
"I'll leave it." I'll leave it by the front door.
He'll be
and
like,
"If it's still there in the morning, it's going in the garbage."
Oh no, no, he'll pick it up tonight. Just it'd be best if you don't answer the door when he comes. Just leave it on the porch, because he'll be like, "Okay, oh, this box, I just would fuck it all night."
Okay.
Like, I'd fuck your box so hard.
Okay. I will leave it by the front door. How's that?
I will fuck this box all over the fucking yard.
Okay, he can have fun.
No, no, it's not me. It's the employee.
I said he can have fun, not you.
Okay, yeah, not me. I'm not like that. I'm married. I'm a married man. I would not fuck your box. I would not fuck your hot little tight box, ma'am.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm a married man. I'm not like that.
Okay.
I'm not. I mean, it's nothing against you or anything. I just, your box is too greasy for me.
Yeah, well, so, are you the manager?
Yeah, my name is Roy Gerbel, and I'm not interested in fucking your box and your tight little box.
Okay.
I'm no interest at all.
I was just wondering if you were the manager the way you're talking.
No.
You should be happy it doesn't offend me, but some people it might.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll put the box out by the front door.
You know that box? Because we mark down each time that the box is used. That box has lasted a long time. We've used it 12 different times now. You're the 12th person to use that same cardboard box.
That's cool.
You'd think it'd be like just filled with bacteria and disease and AIDS. Yeah. AIDS, lots of AIDS. But no, it's fine. It's like... I'm sorry?
Don't be talking about stuff like that.
No, I'm just saying, like, we do a good job with the bleach pneumonia, right?
Yeah, I see that,
You can't even tell it's a used box, even though it's been used.
No, I couldn't.
You are the 12th customer, so it's been used 11 times before you.
Okay. It does say 35% recycled content.
See? I wasn't lying. It's right there on the box. It's right there on that tight little fucking sexy box.
Okay. Yes, it is.
Okay, then.
I'll leave it out by the front door.
Okay. Is that where your husband smokes? Is he going to be out there smoking when we come to pick up the box?
No.
Where does he smoke?
He smokes in the backyard.
Okay. Thank God. I don't want to see his ugly...
What?
Nothing.
No. He's out back. We don't smoke in the front. We smoke in the back.
Yeah. I like it in the back.
Okay. Yeah. In the back.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
So I'll leave it by the front door and he can pick it up.
Okay, and we won't charge you $7.39.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
All right, thanks.
Have a nice night. I hope you liked your pizza.
Yeah, it was good.
Bye.
Thanks.
Whatever, bye. Just hang up.
Good times. It looks like that one's only a year old. I just posted it a year ago. And according to the description on YouTube, Sloth sent me that number for that lady to call her. Back in the good old days when Sloth would send me phone numbers to call on my show. Thanks, Sloth. Okay, so now I feel like it's an appropriate time to end the show. So I'm going to end the show now. This show has been sponsored by Jason Bennett. Jason Bennett is fully responsible for the dozens of people I called today and they did not pick up, or it just wasn't funny. I had to delete it. He's responsible for that threat I made on that guy's voicemail, but then I deleted that because I don't want any trouble. And Jason's responsible for, I don't know, Jayad's Halloween pumpkin, I guess. He can have that. If you liked the portrait calls that I did in today's show and in the last show from last week or this weekend or whenever that happened, listen to Carlito's show from last night, from Sunday night. That was Sunday, October 26th, 2014.
There is a link to it in the show notes. And there are three or four other portrait calls to customers made by Carlito, Jen Stewart. There's at least one by me. It doesn't work out. The one by me doesn't work out. But the ones by Carlito and Jen, they're pretty funny. One more thing before I go. There is now a Mixler stream that runs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's the regular Prank Call Nation Mixler stream. Whenever somebody's not live on the air, you will hear old pranks. It's playing whatever Carlito's playing on his Shoutcast stream. That's what I'm playing on the Mixler stream. I have a dedicated computer now, which is playing stuff on the Mixler stream all day, all night. So now, when you're bored, any time of the day, you can go to the Mixler and listen to old prank calls. Old prank archives, those are the new live shows. Who cares about live shows anymore, right? Who needs those? So you can listen to the Mixler stream on prankcallnation.com. Go to prankcallnation.com/chat, and it'll start up automatically, and you can read all about how to get into the chat room, into our exclusive chat room that's hard to get into, but if you work hard at it, you can get in and hang out with the rest of us. Also, don't forget to support the Phone Losers show on patreon.com/phonelosers or phonelosers.org/cactus. And if you're sick of supporting me and the Snowplow show, you can always support Prank Call Nation at patreon.com/prankcallnation. There, I think I've given you enough URLs so that you're all confused now. I'm going to end the show with a song about the great super hacking god known as Curtis Lee Jones. Here's Play the Game.
Ready to play the game? Let's play the game. Devil says you don't speak until I say so. The devil says your time is up when I say so.
Curtis Lee Jones, a top fucking hacker, is scaring the operator, threatening to smack her. He's saying he'll choke my fucking neck too.
Dude, you don't fucking get it, do you?
I wish I was smarter to find the first clue, but I'm just a punk-ass inbreeded fool.
How stupid can you fucking be?
I guess I need to go to my library. I'm hardly a genius like you are on phones. I don't have a central computer in my home. Tapping my lines and tracing my calls. Jesus, Curtis, you're like a fucking god. How do you get those impression footprints?
You made me a fucking god, bitch.
Crap, what are you gonna do to me, Kurt?
Dude, you should've did your homework.
Let's play the game like the devil says. It's not time to speak until I say it is. Your time is up because the devil says so. You understand that it's the devil's show. Play the rules the way the game is played, or the devil's hands will take your life away. Each step is countered by a step of mine. Just like every time, every fucking time.
You don't understand. I control you, bitch boy. You don't get that, do ya? I'm gonna be fucking laughing as I'm fucking ramming my cock right up your fucking ass, motherfucker. You inbreeded fucking motherfucker. You are fucking stupid. Dude, you don't even have a fucking clue how dumb you are, do you? See, motherfucker, there's three ways you should go about doing things. One, you're not smart enough to even come up with the first fucking clue, asswipe.
Let's play the game like the devil says. It's not time to speak until I say it is. Your time is up because the devil says so. You understand that it's the devil's show. Play the rules the way the game is played, or the devil's hands will take your life away. Each step is countered by a step of mine. Just like every time, every fucking time.
Wow, Curtis, this whole thing's a mess.
I do have a way of getting your address.
I didn't mean to piss off a hacker this much. I just wanted to hear you yell at me a bunch. Now it seems like my whole life is through.
Let me tell you exactly what I'm gonna do.
Can you really find me through the telephone switch?
You best understand who you're fucking with.
Please, Curtis, just let me go free. I'll never call your number again. You'll see. You win this round, Curtis. You're the fucking boss.
Now, motherfucker, you pissed me off.
Actually, I'm kidding. Your threats crack me up. I know you're nothing to be afraid of. Your crazy delusions of your hacker past.
I'm gonna put down a mud hole in your fucking ass.
Let's play the game like the devil says. It's not time to speak until I say it is. Your time is up because the devil says so. You understand that it's the devil's show. Play the rules the way the game is played, or the devil's hands will take your life away. Each step is countered by a step of mine. Just like every time, every fucking time.
operator. This is some punk-ass bitch. Now, if you can't trace him down and send it to the police station, then shut the fuck up. Get off the fucking phone. I'm out with these stupid fucking jackasses. You ain't nothing but a punk-ass bitch. Well, let me tell you this, punk boy. Wait till I go get my hands on your fucking neck. It's a punk-ass little boy that soon will get his teeth knocked out in jail. You're a fucking lame fuck.